Nick Anna, right? Nick Anna? Nicki Minaj?
Yeah.
Well, so bags will get picked up.
I'll let you use my bag.
Holy, we need your glove. Let's go.
Let's go. Come on. Come on. Quick. Come on. Let's go.
Yeah, they're going to go.
Back up.
Why is that a real camera for you?
Does it even work?
This is gonna be on DVD.
Awesome!
Omar, say hello.
Hi, family.
Omar, say hello.
Okay. Good. Bob,
thanks.
Bye. Good.
Everybody do the happy Bob? I'm over here, Fred. You got both.
Here we go. Two.
Five off.
Go up. You get the shin guard done and the helmet.
Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna take the paper. Right. Now ball you on it. Okay, let's go right in front of you. Alex, go get the ball from my back.
Hello everybody, Ken Gonzalez here for George Langevin Productions. We are at the 2013 Scripps Ranch Little League World Series. And we have the AA division right now, the Camo Padres. And they're going up against the 84 Brown Padres. You see the Camo Padres there, going through their starting defensive positions. Beautiful day here, the 8th of June, 2013. We got the first inning just underway, and as you see, it's the Camo Padres, the home team here today. Final warm-up pitches, Declan McCook, number 4. He's the catcher. And Alex Wasilewski, the starting pitcher. Aiden Armstrong will lead things off for the 84 Brown Padres, the first pitch of the 2013 Double A World Series. Coming up, Alex Wasilewski, one final walk around the mound. Now he's ready. Left-hand pitcher. Don't see that too often. Here's the pitch. A little high for ball, and we're underway 1-0. Aiden Armstrong leading things off for the 84 Brown Padres. 1984 Padres, one heck of a year for this squad. Steve Garvey, Tony Gwynn pacing them to the World Series against the Detroit Tigers. Overcast day here at Jarabek Park, and we've been doing the Scripps Ranch Little League for many, many years, and it is kind of off and on. One year it's a little overcast, and the next year it's completely sunny, and that pitch is hit high into the air. The second baseman is there, number 6, Mason Rezonka. Or, I'm sorry, that's Kong Tai. Looking at the 84 roster. So Kong Tai with the catch there at second base. One away. And here's Jacob Pettit. Nice delivery there by that big lefty. Wazalewski. Alex, tall boy there. So if he keeps this up, he could be a foe. A formidable foe once he gets into high school. Big kick. Here's the left-hander's pitch, and it's a ground ball to Kong Tai over to first in time. Two away, playing first base, Nick McKinstry, number 14.
Ready to make the play, guys.
And here comes Mason Rezonka. Mason looks at the first pitch outside, one ball, no strikes. First inning just underway, two outs. Alex's next pitch, a little bit up and away. Two balls and no strikes. The 2-0 pitch in the dirt, 3-0. So Mason looking to get aboard here, the first base runner for the 84 Brown Padres. On deck, Nick Aguilar. The 3-0 pitch is in there for a strike, 3-1. So Mason working that count. He had the pitch of 3-0, now it's 3-1. Let's see what he gets. The 3-1 pitch is in there on a bounce, ball four. And so Mason Rezonka, first runner here of the game. And here's Nick Aguilar with two out, a runner on first base, no score. Nick looks at the first pitch, up and in, and in fact it got him. And actually got him right on top of the, right where the back meets the behind there. It was a strange pitch, the way the catcher went up there. It looks like it was going to be up and in, and the ball actually went behind Aguilar and hit him. So first and second, two outs. And here's Ben Gass. And Alex's pitch, taking third base, number six, Mason Rezonka. And let's see, over to second base, yes, goes Nick Aguilar. So 1-0 the count. Runners in scoring position, two outs here in the first inning. Swing and a miss. Daniel Kim is on deck, and then Joshua Friedenberg. But there are two outs, so let's see what happens to Ben Gass here. Swing and a miss. And it's a ball and two strikes. Aguilar taking his lead off second. The Camo Padres, the Wazalewski Padres, home team today. And the 1-2 pitch, curveball in there for a strike. And down goes Gass. So the 84 Brown Padres will leave two. We head to the bottom of the first inning. No score. John Auger there, number two. He's playing right field for the 84 Brown Padres. Noah Simpauco, number seven, in center field. Adam Snyder, number eight, in left. At first base, Daniel Kim, number 12. Joshua Friedenberg, number 11, or number one, that is, second base. At shortstop, Aiden Armstrong, number nine. And the third baseman, number four, Carson Baranek. on the mound, or behind the plate, Jacob Pettit, number 5, and on the mound, number 14, Nick Aguilar.
Batting, Doug Farre.
All right, Doug Farre leading things off here for the Camo Padres. Bottom of the first, the 2013 Double-A Scripps Ranch Little League World Series. The first pitch swung on and hit hard over to shortstop. Picks it up there over to first. Oh, he drops the ball. I had got a little ahead of myself. Number 9, Aiden Armstrong, the shortstop. Couldn't handle it. And on board is Doug Farre. That'll bring up Alex Costello.
Now batting Alex Costello.
So Costello. Let's see if they try to have him move the runner over. If he's hitting for a base hit, I would assume this early in the game, he's just swinging away. Nice stance, makes himself small. Costello looks at a pitch outside, one ball. Next pitch is swung on, hit into the air, and it's going to drop in front of the center fielder. And there's runners at first and second, nobody out. Number 7, Noah Simpauco gets the ball back in. And nobody out here in the first inning for the Camo Padres. And that'll bring up Kang Tai, number 6, hitting third in the lineup. With a chance to do some damage here against Nick Aguilar. Nick's first pitch just outside, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch outside. 2-0 gets away from the catcher, Pettit. Everybody moves up, and the throw is going to get into left field, but the runners will hold. And there's runners now, second and third, nobody out. That pitch is high. On deck, Alex Wasluski. That pitch is hit into the air, down the right field line, foul. Just past his dugout, the Camo dugout. The next pitch by Aguilar is high and away, ball 4. So the bases are loaded, nobody out here for the Camo Padres, and that'll bring up starting pitcher.
Now batting Alex Wasluski.
Alex Wasluski. First pitch, big swing and a miss, 0-1. Aguilar goes right at him. Wasluski with a huge swing looking for that grand slam. Aguilar's one strike pitch. Inside, a ball and a strike. There's nowhere to put him, so he's got to get over the plate here. Next pitch on the outside corner for a strike. 0-2, so Aguilar ahead in the count now. Let's see if Wasluski will shorten up his swing here, try to just put the ball into play. Taps on the plate a couple of times. You see the runner there at second. Here's the pitch. Outside, ball 1-2. Aguilar tried to go right back to the same well there. He's got that outside call a pitch before, but this one a bit further out. The 1-2 pitch, again outside. They're trying to keep it away from the wheelhouse there of Alex Wasluski. Going outside with the pitches. The 2-2 pitch. Swung on, hit into the air into left field, and it will drop into the gap. One run scores, two runs will score on a single by Alex Wasilewski and the Camo Padres with a 2-0 lead here in the first inning of the 2013 Scripps Ranch Little League AA World Series. And that pitch is hit into left field, caught by the left fielder. Nice play there. Zach Lafer, number 11, hit it hard. But number 8, the left fielder, Adam Snyder, is there. One down, two runners on.
Next up, Declan McCook.
And here's Declan McCook. On deck is Jacob Adams. Swung on, tapped, foul up the third baseline. 0-1 the count to Declan McCook. Aguilar having to work here in the first inning. First four batters reach base before the fly out by Zach Lafer. The next pitch, swung on, popped up in the infield. The catcher looks up, and I think it's going to be on the screen. No balls and two strikes. Jacob Pettit behind the plate. The 0-2 pitch hit into the air towards left field, and it's going to bounce just past the third baseman's glove. Just over the outstretched hands of the third baseman there. And the bases are loaded for Jacob Adams.
Now batting, Jacob Adams.
So one out, bases loaded, two runs are in. Bottom of the first inning, the Camo Padres lead the 84 Brown Padres. Infielders doing their maneuvering around the runners. Next pitch is hit on the ground, up the first baseline, foul, then rolls fair, but I believe it touched part of that backstop, hit the pole and came back in. So that'll be a foul ball for a strike. Swung on, hit on a bounce, past the pitcher. Nice play by the second baseman. Steps on the bag for one. Nice play by number one, Joshua Friedenberg. A run scored, but he saved a run by not allowing that ball to get through the infield. So 3-0, Campbell Padres could very well be 4-0. Nice play by Joshua Friedenberg. And here is Nick McKinstry, the 8th batter of the inning. Aguilar looking to get out of this inning. In there for a strike to McKinstry, 0-1. Nice play by Joshua Friedenberg. Even nicer for him to have the wherewithal to just say, hey, I just need to tag the bag with my glove, and I'll get the force out. The next pitch is hit into the air past the center fielder. He is playing in. Two runs will score. And heading to third base, McKinstry, and he'll make it with a two-out triple. And they've hit the allotted amount of runs that you can have in an inning. So we've played one here at the Scripps Ranch Little League AA World Series. The 84 Brown Padres coming up. The Camo Padres with a 5-0 lead. And welcome back to Jarabek Park, everybody. Ken Gonzalez for George Langevin Productions bringing you another game
first
of the week.
Padres
We're here at the 2013 Scripps Ranch Little League. We're in the second inning, just to start the second inning, and Daniel Kim leading it off for the 84 Brown Padres. Wasilewski, the lefty, comes inside. Ball a bit low, and it's 1-0. The 1-0 pitch, low ball 2, 2-0. Wasilewski deals 2-0 right down the middle of the plate. Two balls and one strike. One pitch swung on, hit into the air down the right field line, foul. Evens it up, two balls, two strikes. So Alex Wasilewski already on the mound, on the rubber, ready to go. Umpire puts it back into play, the 2-2 pitch. Swung on, lined right back to Alex, and Wasilewski just nonchalantly puts up that mitt right next to his right ear, and he makes the play, laughing all the while. One down, and here's Joshua Friedenberg. Made that great play at second base in the bottom of the first inning, saved a run. At the time, run eventually scored on that triple, but a nice play. As he rolled to his right, stopped the ball from going up the middle, and tagged the bag with his glove, and he's going to line that one. Foul up the first baseline, 0-1. Sun trying to make its way through the clouds here this beautiful June day. Inside. And the next pitch is bounced just past Wasilewski to the second baseman. Tie over to first in time, just in time to get the speedy Joshua Friedenberg.
Now batting.
Kang Tai.
Nolan the Crusher Boyer.
And here's Nolan Boyer with two outs for the 84 Brown Padres. Adam Snyder is on deck. If Boyer can get on, we'll see him. Otherwise, we'll wait till the third. Swing and a foul back. 0-1 the count. So Wasilewski back on the mound. He's got a nice rhythm. Gets the ball and wants to deliver it. Swung on, bounced right back to Alex. Steps, turns, fires to first base in time. 1-2-3 go the 84 Brown Padres. We head to the bottom of the second inning here at Jerbeck Park. It's the Camo Padres 5, the 84 Brown Padres 0. And welcome back. Omar Nuhili will lead things off for the Camo Padres. The Wasilewski Padres against the Armstrong Padres here. Armstrong, the 84 Brown Padres. And Aguilar's first pitch is outside 1-0. Both pitchers today, big, tall kids. One lefty, one righty. Aguilar looks in for the sign, sets. Both pitchers, well, actually, I'm not going to say that, as Wasilewski was, he was switching it up mostly out of the windup. But Aguilar here likes to work out of the stretch. And he'll do it again. And his next pitch is swung on, hit the short, nice play across the middle of the diamond, firing to first base in time. Nice play by number 12, Daniel Kim.
Now batting number three, Abel Walker.
And that'll bring up Abel Walker, 10th batter here in the lineup for the Camo Padres. They've got 13. And Aguilar's pitch is in there for a strike, 0-1. Aguilar, just like his counterpart Wasilewski, likes to work fast. 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss, 0-2. Gets by Pettit, the catcher. Nobody on base. And the 0-2 pitch by Aguilar is outside. Tried to get Abel to chase something there, but Walker wouldn't have it. And it's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Down goes Walker. And there are two down here in the bottom of the second inning. And so that wild first inning, five runs across for the Camo Padres. But now, if you count the top of the second inning, 1-2-3, and now 1-2. So a very quiet second inning. And here's Spencer Thompson. Aguilar's pitch just up, 1-0. Aguilar deals the 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss, 1-1. One pitch fouled up the first baseline. So just a little bit late on that swing. One ball, two strikes to Spencer Thompson. And now the 1-2 pitch is just a little outside again, as he did with Abel Walker. Aguilar tries to force the issue outside, looking for Thompson to chase something out of the zone. And Aguilar's next pitch. Ooh, and boy, you sure can't tell. Spencer Thompson wanted to swing at that. It never did come down. Thompson was locked and ready to go. But the ball stayed up, and his back stayed back. He didn't offer at it. And what will Aguilar give him here? Outside again, ball four. So a two-out walk issued to Spencer Thompson. And that'll bring up number seven, Tyler Lyons.
Number seven, Tyler Lyons.
So Aguilar's first pitch to Tyler is up and in, 1-0. On deck, Kobe Germain, and a steal by Spencer Thompson. So now with two outs, a runner in scoring position for the Camo Padres. And that pitch is swung on and foul back, 0-1. Aguilar climbs the mound, kicks at the rubber. Now he's looking in for the sign, comes set, and the pitch to Lyons. Swung on, bounce foul behind the plate, two strikes. Two out, bottom of the second inning, Camo Padres with a 5-0 lead. Another runner in scoring position. That's Spencer Thompson after his steal of second base. Aguilar's pitch, Swung on and foul back again. And yet again on the foul ball. So Tyler Lyons hanging tough in the box there. Fouling everything off he can. And it's been everything so far. Aguilar's next pitch is outside. Again, wanting to have that batter chase that outside pitch. I believe it's either 1-2 or 2-2 to Tyler Lyons. And that pitch behind him. Full count, 3 balls, 2 strikes to Tyler Lyons. Aguilar would love to get him here. The 3-2 pitch. Outside, ball 4. So runners at first and second, 2 outs. And here's Kobe Germain. Pitch to Germain is outside, gets away from the catcher. The runner's going to move up. And so runners now at second and third base for the Camo Padres. Now a meeting at the mound. Is he coach? Not sure if that's Coach Armstrong. Out there to talk to his pitcher, Nick Aguilar. And now he returns to the third base side. Into that dugout. And now Aguilar took heed of what he had to say. In there for a strike, 0-1. The 0-1 pitch. Low and away. 1 ball, 1 strike. After Germain, you've got Doug Fari and Alex Costello back to the top of the lineup for the Camo Padres. Bottom of the second inning. Aguilar's pitch. That's in there. Nicely swinging and a foul back. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Again, Aguilar set the 1-2 pitch, is in there for a strike. Nice pitch. And the batter, Germain, thought it might stay high, but it comes in there nicely. No runs for the Camo Padres. They leave 2. We go to the third inning, 5-0. Camo Padres over the 84 Brown Padres. All right, welcome back, everybody. Ken Gonzalez, Georgia Langevin Productions. Top of the third inning.
Adam Schneider.
Here at the AA Scripps Ranch Little League World Series. And for the 84 Brown Padres, Adam Schneider will lead things off against Alex Wasilewski. 5-0 Camo Padres. Wasilewski deals that nice left-handed leg kick. In there for a strike, 0-1. Wasilewski slowing it down just a bit. He was in a nice fast rhythm the first couple of innings. Now slowing it down. 0-2 the count to Adam Schneider with his team, the 84 Brown Padres, trailing here in the third inning, 5-0. He The sun is ducked behind more of that cloud cover once again. The 0-2 pitch is hit on the ground to the second baseman. Nice flip over to first by Kung Tai. And there's one away. And that'll bring up Carson Baranek.
Carson Baranek.
So Carson playing third base, I believe, for the 84 Brown Padres. Takes the first pitch high and away. One ball and no strikes. So Alex Wasilewski just kind of cruising right now. Remember that second inning, he caught a line drive right back at him and then fielded a ground ball. So an unassisted and then an assist as he threw out the third out at first base. Noah Simpauco is on deck. And then John Auger, if anybody should get aboard. Alex's pitch is in there for a strike. Nice pitch. Right around the plate. Most of the game here. Same with Nick Aguilar, his counterpart. But the bats have been red hot for the Camo Padres. So two balls, two strikes to Carson. The 2-2 pitch is just up. Ball three, full count, 3-2. Alex looks in for the sign out of the windup, and the 3-2 pitch is high, ball four. So a one-out walk, and here's Noah Simpauco.
Now batting number seven, Noah Simpauco.
Left-hander's pitch is swung on and missed. Stayed on that outside corner. And Simpauco swings right through it, 0-1. Alex going right back to work, the 0-1 pitch. In there on the outside corner. 1-0-2. One out, runner on first base, top of the third inning. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on and grounded to short. Can they turn two? Beats him to the bag at second. So a force out. Nice job there by the Camo shortstop, number one, Doug Fari. Two outs. And that'll bring up John Ager. Left-hand batter. So lefty against lefty here with two outs and a runner on first. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Simpauco there on first. 5-0, Camo Padres. Next pitch just outside. One ball, one strike. Lefty kicks, deals, swing, and a ground ball foul just outside of third there into the Brown Padres dugout, or just past the dugout. Next pitch is high. Wasilewski trying to make him chase something there. John Ager. Wasilewski, he does it. He gets ahead in the count, then he tries to force the batter into chasing something up and away or low and away. A steal of second, and he's going to make it. So Noah Simpauco will steal second base. And with two outs, a runner in scoring position now for John Auger. And that pitch is in there for a strike, and down he goes. And that'll do it for the 84 Brown Padres in the top of the third. They leave a runner, Noah Simpauco, at second. We go to the bottom of the third inning. It's the Camo Padres 5 and the 84 Brown Padres nothing. New pitcher now for the 84 Brown Padres. Number 6, Mason Rozanka. And he'll face Doug Farre to lead things off. And Mason's first pitch is fouled away, 0-1. Zonka really bringing it now. Pitch on the outside corner, 0-2. And the 0-2 pitch is inside. One ball, two strikes. Rozanka's 1-2 pitch is bounced over to second. Nice pickup and to first base. He drops the ball, gets right back on the bag, and he's got him. So Joshua Friedenberg gets the ball over to the first baseman. I believe that's John Ager now. One away for Alex Costello. Outside, 1-0. Mason looks in for the sign, the 1-0 pitch. Big swing and a miss. So you take away that bottom of the first inning for the Camo Padres, and it's a 0-0 game. We're here in the bottom of the third. Inside. And that pitch is high. So Mason Rozanka can really bring it. And low and away, ball 4. So a one-out walk issued to Alex Costello, and that'll bring up the second baseman for the Camo Padres.
Camo Padres, number 6, Kang Tai.
And here's Kang Tai. And that pitch is going to get away from the catcher, and over to second base goes Alex Costello on the pass ball. Bottom of the third, 5-0 Camo Padres. One out, and they're looking to add another run here. Pitch is high. Umpire back there doing a pretty good job. Balls that are, you know, too high or too outside, too low, he's giving them the ball. And something that's right around the corner. You know, these kids at this age are not going to be right on the plate every time. You can't give it just that to them. You got to open it up just a little bit. But he's doing a pretty good job. There's a walk. And now there's runners at first and second with one out. And that'll bring up Alex Wazlewski, left-hand batter, left-hand pitcher, starting pitcher for the Camo Padres. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Wazlewski, I believe, reached first base his first time. A big hack there, the 0-1 pitch by Mason. In there for a strike, 0-2. Nice pitch on the inside part of the plate. just above the belt. Nice pitch. He rocks, deals, and the 0-2 to Wasilewski is hit on the ground towards first. Picked up nicely by the first baseman to get the out on Wasilewski. John Ager, nice play. Two outs, runners move up to second and third. And that'll bring up Zach Lafer. Both teams doing a great job of fielding the ball here today. Not too many errors, if any. They've recovered a few times. That play at first base just a few batters ago. Able to get the out. Ball 1-1 and 0. And then Friedenberg, remember, made that nice play in the second inning. Actually, it was the first inning. Diving play. And he was able to tag second base for the force out. High. Rozanka works quickly, pitches hit into the air, and caught by the shortstop, number 14, Nick Aguilar. He was a starting pitcher. And so the Camo Padres again turned away. We've played three complete at the Scripps Ranch Little League AA World Series. Camo Padres 5, 84 Brown Padres nothing. Fourth inning coming right up.
Now pitching for the Camo Padres, number 11, Zach Lafer.
And welcome back. Top of the fourth inning. A new pitcher taking over for Wasilewski, number 11, Zach Lafer. And Aiden Armstrong leading it off for the 84 Brown Padres. Their leadoff hitter leading off here in the fourth. Pitches a ball, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch is swung on and foul back. One ball, one strike. One pitches up and away. Two balls, one strike. Leading off here the fourth inning. 5-0 Camo Padres. Outside. So Aiden Armstrong with a count 3-1 is looking for a leadoff walk. On deck is Jacob Pettit. Then you've got Mason Rozanka and Nick Aguilar. Beautiful day here, Saturday the 8th of June, 2013, Jarabek Park, Scripps Ranch, California. And that pitch is inside, ball four. So a leadoff walk by Armstrong. And let's see if Lafer can recover here and find the zone. And that pitch is hit in the air, foul, down the right field line. And the next pitch is high. Lafer deals, and that's high and in. So the 84 Padres with a chance to rally here in the top of the fourth inning. They trail by only five. They've got a runner on, nobody out. And that pitch is swung on, hit into the air to the second baseman on a bounce, flicks to first. In time, just in time. Aiden Armstrong moves over to second base.
Number six, Mason, the crusher, Rozanka.
And Mason Rozanka now batting with a runner in scoring position. Nice pitch in there for a strike, 0-1. So Lafer trying to work his way out of this jam. Runner on second, one out, top of the fourth. Pitch high, a ball and a strike. The next pitch is bounced up third and foul. Number 7, Tyler Lyons, comes over and gets it back to his pitcher. So in the hole is Mason, Nick Aguilar on deck. Two strikes. Here's the pitch. That's a ball. Gets away from the catcher, moving over to third and making it is Aiden Armstrong. Had the slide there at the end. Made it close. Lafer's next pitch is hit on the right side. The pitcher over to first in time. They go to the plate, not in time, and the 84 Padres are on the board. It's now 5-1. So a nice job of hitting by Mason Rosenka going the other way, driving in the runner from third. And that'll bring up Nick Aguilar. Two outs and nobody on. That pitch is a strike on the outside corner. If Aguilar can extend the inning, Ben Gass would then come to bat. And that pitch is just a little bit inside. Lafer now moving slowly back up the mound. Quickly on the rubber, though. And quickly set. He knows what he wants to throw. Here's the pitch just outside. So Nick Aguilar trying to work the pitcher right here. And the next pitch to Aguilar is bounced off the third baseman and down the left field line. A single for Aguilar, and let's hope that the third baseman there is okay. See, that's Tyler Lyons. There's a strike, 0-1. Ball high into the air, going to second base and making it is Aguilar. As the ball hit the backstop. Swing and a miss. Mike, pitch, just a little bit high. And so Ben Gass trying to work the count here, trying to drive home Nick Aguilar with the second run for the 84 Padres. Swung on and fouled away. On the outside corner, strike three call. Down goes Ben Gass looking. So Lafer will get out of the inning, giving up just the one run. But for the 84 Brown Padres, are on the board. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. It's the Camo Padres 5, the 84 Brown Padres 1. And welcome back to Jerbeck Park. Ken Gonzalez for Georgia Landrum Productions. And Declan McCook will lead it off for the Camo Padres. Inside. Mason Rozanka. Starting a second inning of work here for the 84 Brown Padres. And that pitch is inside. And that pitch in there for a strike. So let's see if he can battle his way back here. And that's in there for a strike. Two strikes now on Declan McCook. And the count is full as he's battling his way back. I believe it was 3-0, now 3-2. Here's the pitch. Swung on, hit into the air to center field. It'll drop. A leadoff single for Declan McCook.
Now batting for the Camo Padres, number 9, Jacob Adams.
Jacob Adams now batting. Fouls it. Let's see, it's in the air to first. Caught on the line drive by the first baseman. And they're going to double up Declan McCook, number 8 for the Brown Padres. Adam Snyder with a beautiful play. The unassisted double play. Boy, I thought that ball was going to be out of play. It was down the line. And a nice snag there. And the double play. So a huge play. And let's see if Mason Rozanka can get out of the inning now. That's the 84 Padres. They only trail by 4 runs. And that's in there for a strike. On the corner. So now Mason, a pitch away from just getting out of the inning as quickly as he can. Rocks, deals, and the pitch is low. The next pitch is hit into the air to right field and foul. Let's go, Nolan, be ready. The next pitch swung on, fouled away. So Nick McKinstry staying alive there. And the next pitch is up and away. Mason's next pitch swung on and missed, and down he goes, so he'll get out of the inning as McKinstry strikes out. Nice job there. And we have now played four innings here at the 2013 Scripps Ranch Little League AA World Series. Camo Padres 5, Brown Padres 1.
Now pitching for the Camo Padres, Alex Costello.
All right, welcome. Ken Gonzalez for George Lange of Air Productions. Top of the fifth inning. And for the Camo Padres, now pitching is Alex Costello. And Daniel Kim steps in for the 84 Brown Padres. They trail 5-1. And that pitch is in there for a strike, 0-1. And the 0-1 pitch fouled away. And so quickly, Daniel Kim in the hole, 0-2.
Nick, you ready? Pitcher.
Hey. 0-2 pitch, just low. So Costello was ahead 0-2, now the count 2-2 to Daniel Kim. Again, we're at Jarabek Park, the 8th of June, 2013, the AA Scripps Ranch Little League World Series. And that ball is bounced to the first baseman. Nice job, foot race to the bag, not in time. And so Daniel Kim is aboard. Number one, Doug Fari, made the play on the ball, moved to his right, but then had a foot race back to the bag. And Kim beat it. And here's Joshua Friedenberg. And time running down on the Padres, the 84 Padres. So now would be a good time to rally. They trail 5-1. Costello's next pitch swing and a miss. 1-1. Nolan Boyer is on deck. And that pitch is outside the runner, Kim to second base, and he'll make it with the steal. Declan McCook put the tag down, but not in time. And a runner in scoring position now for Joshua Friedenberg. And that pitch is inside, gets away from the catcher, and over to third base goes a very speedy Daniel Kim. Costello's next pitch gets away from the catcher. The runner's going to try to score, and Kim is going to make it. So Daniel Kim with a leadoff infield single, steals second, moves to third and home on the pass balls. And it's now the Camo Padres 5 and the 84 Brown Padres 2. So it's a three-run World Series game. And here's Nolan Boyer with a runner on first, swing and a miss, 0-1. The tying run in the on-deck circle, if Boyer can get aboard. fouled away. Quickly in the hole, two strikes. On first base, Joshua Friedenberg, who walked.
Yes, Jacob.
That's a ball. Quickly, Costello works. Out of the stretch, here comes the pitch. Swung on and missed. And so Nolan Boyer is down on strike. One away, and that'll bring up Adam Snyder.
Armstrong team, number 8, Adam the Shady Snyder.
So Adam Snyder trying to continue the inning here. Only one out. And he's going to bounce that one foul past the third base bag. Kinstry gets it back into his pitcher, Costello. And that pitch gets away from the catcher, and moving over to second base is Joshua Friedenberg. And Friedenberg will send or take off to third base on that pass ball.
No, I know, I really like that. No, no, it's like this.
And that pitch is high. So Costello being made to work here by the 84 Brown Padres. The pitch. Nice backhand stop by the catcher. And Snyder will walk. And that'll bring up Carson Baranek. Runners at first and third. Little meeting there. On the mound for the Camo Padres.
Now batting for Armstrong, number 4, Carson Baranek.
So let's see what Carson can do here. First pitch low for a ball. And the next pitch to Carson is inside, 2-0. And so the Campbell Padres certainly don't want to load the bases. The tying run would be at first base, and there's only one out. They've led since the first. They scored 5, but nothing since. And in the meanwhile, the 84 Brown Padres have been chipping away, and they only trail by 3. It's 5-2. Top of the 5th inning. That ball to the backstop, but the runner at third, Friedenberg, will stay. And number 8, Adam Snyder to second. He's got a huge lead as he stares down the pitcher. Now he's got to go back. Here's the pitch. And that'll get away from the catcher. And again, very cautiously, they'll hold Friedenberg at third. There's only one out, first base open. There's no reason. You're down by 3 to chance being out at the plate right now with only one out. And that pitch is in there for a strike, and down goes Baranek, and that'll leave it up to Noah Simpauko. So Noah with 2 outs, runners at second and third, a base hit could pull his team to within a run. Costello's pitch is inside, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. is swung on, hit into the air, just past the second baseman into right field. One run will score. They're going to hold. Snyder at third, into second base goes Noah Simpauco. And the 84 Brown Padres here in the top of the fifth keep the inning alive. A clutch two out single, taking second on a throw to home for Noah Simpauco, and that'll bring up John Ager. It's a 5-3 ball game. So two runs across here for the 84 Brown Padres. A base hit could tie the game, 1-0. And that pitch is outside. Two balls and no strikes. They're probably going to not give John Ager anything to pull. They might want to keep everything on the outside part of the plate. The 2-0 pitch is again outside, 3-0. On deck, the leadoff batter, Aiden Armstrong. And that pitch is low and away, ball four. So a four-pitch walk. And here's Aiden Armstrong, the go-ahead run, now on base at first for the 84 Brown Padres. And that pitch is in there for a strike. Costello battling his way out of this inning. He's had to work. And the next pitch is hit into right field and foul. Armstrong hit that ball probably just below the barrel. It stung his hand, you see there. But he's back in. And Costello's pitch is a ball. Again a ball. And so now Costello is going to be in danger of walking in the fourth run for the 84 Padres. Nice pitch, and it's drilled near the gap in left center field. The center fielder comes to get it. A run scores. Everybody moves up 90 feet. It's 5-4. And the tying run at third base for the 84 Brown Padres. They battled their way all the way back, and that pitch is high, 1-0. Said 90 feet, but of course, these youngsters ain't exactly on the 90-foot base path fields. And I would believe they're 80. Swung on and slap, foul, just outside the first baseline. And that pitch fouled away. So Jacob Pettit staying alive here for the 84 Brown Padres. If he can get a single here, he'll definitely tie the game, and he could put his squad ahead if the runner from second can score. Here's the pitch, swung on and missed, and down goes Pettit. But the 84 Padres clawing their way back. They get three runs and will head to the bottom of the fifth inning. It's the Camo Padres 5 and the 84 Brown Padres 4. All right, welcome back. Bottom of the fifth inning, number 9. Aiden Armstrong now pitching for the 84 Brown Padres. Out. Slow delivery by Armstrong. Curveball outside. Pitch foul back. So now the pressure could be on the Camo Padres. They had the 5-0 lead. It's now 5-4. Now Healy swings, doesn't get it. 2-2. Swing and a miss, and down he goes. So number 8, Omar Nahili strikes out, and here's Abel Walker. Walker with a swing and a miss, 0-1. Walker will drive this one to the second baseman, caught on the fly, snaring the line drive. Number 1, Joshua Friedenberg. And there are two away here in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Spencer Thompson.
And here is Spencer Thompson, number 5, with two outs, bottom of the fifth. Pitch outside, 1-0. And the next pitch in there for a strike. So Thompson is going to have to battle now. Tyler Lyons is on deck. Swung on and missed. So not a bad job of pitching here for Aiden Armstrong in the 84 Brown Padres. And that pitch is outside. And that pitch is swung on, bounced towards first, foul. What a game here. The AA World Series, Scripps Ranch Little League 2013, started with a flurry, 5-0 in the first inning for the Camo Padres. And we're here in the bottom of the fifth. It's now 5-4. That's the 84 Brown Padres. Scored 3 in the top of the inning. Swing and a miss. Down he goes. 1-2-3 inning for the 84 Brown Padres. Defensively, nice job. Nice job of pitching for Aiden Armstrong. We head to the sixth inning of play. The Camo Padres 5 and the 84 Brown Padres 4.
Armstrong 4. Now up, number 6, Mason Rezinga.
Yeah. All right, leading off the top of the sixth inning for the 84 Brown Padres, Mason Rosenka. First pitch swing and a foul tip, 0-1. The 0-1 pitch, and Costello resets. Last inning, you heard some fans yelling for a balk, and it was by Costello a couple of times, but at this age level, I'm not sure you're going to get any balk calls. Just learning what to do up there on the mound, inside. So definitely no intent to deceive anybody out there. But I'm sure some parents sitting on the edge of their seats wanting their sons to win, trying to get a run any way they can. Here's the pitch, and that's low for a ball. So a leadoff walk issued now to Mason Rosenka. And here's number 14, Nick Aguilar. Nick, remember the starting pitcher of this game way back in the first inning when we started. The tying run on first base for the 84 Brown Padres. Swung on, hit high into the air into center field. And underneath it there with a nice catch, number 3, Abel Walker. Nice job as Aguilar gave it a ride, and Walker goes back and makes the catch. And he's certainly a happy center fielder right now. And here's Ben Gass. Costello's pitch to Ben, swing and a miss. Gets away from the catcher, over to second, and making it is number 6, Mason Rosenka. And the tying run in scoring position now for the 84 Brown Padres. Pitch is high. One out in the inning. Swing and a miss, trying to head to third base and making it on the steal is Rosenka. So Ben Gass now with a, something to the right side of the infield or a base hit can tie the game. Costello set. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. And down goes Gass. And here's Daniel Kim. Remember, Kim had the infield hit the last inning, came all the way around to score on a stolen base and a couple of pass balls. Really got the rally going for the 84 Brown Padres. And that's low. Nice block by the catcher. And that pitch in there for a strike. Outside corner, nice pitch. Joshua Friedenberg is on deck, but it's going to be up to Kim to extend the inning. There's two outs, runner at third base. The tying run. And it's going to get away from the catcher. Here he comes, a throw to the plate, not in time. And Mason Rosenka has tied the game, 5-5. And getting a few congratulations there in the dugout. Guys are getting hugged that were just watching. So the pressure a little bit off of Kim now, but heck, he'd like to get on base and score the go-ahead run. in there for a strike. Daniel knew it. He knew he should have swung at that pitch. It's a pitch he wanted. Fouled away. Got a piece of the umpire's mask. And that's why he wears one. And that pitch is going to hit Kim. And now with two outs, the go-ahead run is at first base. And here's Joshua Friedenberg. Catcher wanted to go and throw it to first base and try to catch Kim. Thought better of it. One of those things that would break the game open. You throw it down the line, all of a sudden the runner's on third or even scores. So you don't want to make an error in that situation. Better to hold on to the ball. Kind of a safety throw. The runner was already back, and he didn't fire it over. Just kind of threw it over to first base. Not too much to gamble right there. And Friedenberg looks at a ball. And the next pitch is fouled away. Costello set. Here's the pitch. Can he get out of the inning? Bounces away from the catcher. Over to second base goes Kim, and now he's in scoring position with two outs. And that pitch is bounced to second, up with it, over to first base in time. So Kong Tai over to first, and that'll do it. But the tying run scores for the 84 Brown Padres. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning. We're tied at five. All right, bottom of the sixth inning, Kobe Germain. Leading things off. That's a ball, 1-0. A score will win the game and the World Series for the Camo Padres. We're tied at five. Swing and a miss. Here's the pitch. That's a bit high. Number nine, Aiden Armstrong. Second inning of work here. And that pitch will bounce up there. So he's doesn't want to put the leadoff runner on base. Here's the pitch, and that's a ball, ball four. And so leadoff batter, Kobe Germain, draws the walk, and that'll bring up Doug Farre. Thank you. All right, so the meeting on the mound is over. And that pitch is going to be bounced over to second to short for the one out in time. Nice play by the Padres, the 84 Brown Padres. They get the lead runner, number 12, with a heads-up play, Daniel Kim. Nice play. At first base is Fari, and here's Alex Costello. That pitch is a ball, and over to second. Now he thought about going, but no steal attempt. That pitch inside, two balls now. Swung on, hit into the air. And the shortstop, number six, Mason Rezanka, makes the play. And there are two outs now. And that'll bring up Kang Tai. So Kang Tai with a runner at first base. Two outs, bottom of the sixth inning, we're tied at five. The 2013 Scripps Ranch Little League AA World Series. That pitch in there for a strike. Throw to second base. And a steal. So Fari with the steal. And now the winning run in scoring position. Two outs. Can't get much more exciting than that. Tie awaits the pitch. Bounces away. To third goes Fari. And now the winning run at third base. And you see the third baseman there, number eight, can't control himself. Adam Snyder. It's just getting to be too much now. Here's the pitch. In there for a strike. Gets away, but not far enough to send the runner. Fari. Rozenka looks in for the sign. Winning run at third. Here's the pitch. High. It up and out. He's set. Here's the pitch. That's in there on the corner. Strike three called. They'll leave the winning run at third base, and that will do it for the AA World Series. And we will have co-World Series champions. We've played six innings, tied at five, 5-0. The Camo Padres jumped out to the lead. And it was the 84 Brown Padres coming back, tying it in the top of the sixth inning. And the Camo Padres leaving the winning run at third. Wow, what a great game. And that's what these World Series games are all about, a 5-5 tie. Ken Gonzalez, George Lange, Jermaine Productions, we hope you enjoyed this game. It was my pleasure to bring it to you. There you have it, the AA Scripps Ranch Little League World Series 2013 5-5. Hope to see you all at the 2014 Scripps Ranch Little League. Have a great one, everybody.
Even old people have Instagram.
John, you guys, look over here real quick. John, look over here real quick. Smile, do something.
How are you guys?
Got it, thank you.
So without further ado, Marcus, why don't you come on up and introduce your team? very much, parents, for all your hard work and keeping us in line this year. So thank you. Good work, Jacob. So I'm going to introduce my coaches first. I have Corey Gass is one of my assistant coaches, and my other assistant coach is John Aguilar. So these 84 Brown Padres that played very well. We lost our first playoff game and had to play out. We had to win out to get here, so they've played extremely well in the last couple weeks, and I'm super proud of this team. So we're gonna start with Carson Barnack. Cop out there, Carson. Let's see. Next up, Mr. Benjamin Gass. Number five. He doesn't even know. Jacob. Funny, half of them know their numbers. All right, so Noah Zimpaco. Let's see, Nolan Boyer. John Hager. Adam Snyder, number 8. Number 12, Daniel Kim. Number 14, Nicholas Aguilera. Number 1, Josh Friedenberg. Number 6, Mason Rosenko. That's everybody, right? Oh, we forgot. Number 9, Aiden Armstrong.
I want to thank everybody as well, all the parents, for the support this year. It's been a long season. I think it's great that we're camouflaged because we snuck up on everybody this year. You guys have no idea we're going to play this way in the playoffs, right? Yeah, you guys, we topped our number of wins for the season. Okay, in playoffs, we beat the number of games we won in the regular season. So that's awesome. You guys did great. Every game up, right? And for anybody that doesn't know, this is because it's a Cinderella story. I challenged the boys. So I started with the tutu and tiara. We added the wig. I got high heels and makeup. So it's been a great season. Okay? So let's start off. I'm just going to go down the order. I don't know your number, so I'm just going to say it. So, Spencer Thompson. Oh, sorry, I forgot my coaches. So I've got Rob Lafer over here and James DeSella. James,
get out there, James.
You gotta get in the pictures. All right, then we have Jacob Adams. And with a little bit bigger lip today, Tyler Lyons. We got Kang Tai. We got Mr. Alex Costello. And Abel Walker. Guys, you gotta move those guys on. I got Zach Lafer. We got Nick McKinstry. We got Kobe Germain. We got Declan McCook.
listen to me every single night when I go home. Mr. Alex Wasilewski.
Where's your shirt?
Both teams did great today. Great battle out there.
Yeah.
What? Where's this one?
He didn't want me to wear this.
Which one was my last?
Hey, maybe if we get a good picture, somebody.
I want smile.
Smile.
I feel like the paparazzi's out there.
I love the
Aiden, today you pitched and you played shortstop. What's your favorite position?
Pitcher.
Why is that?
Because I get to strike everybody out.
Was it exciting to pitch the last pitch of the season?
Yeah.
What's your favorite subject in school, Aiden?
Math.
Math? Are you going to come back and play for the Padres again next year?
Yeah.
Thank you, Aiden.
Welcome.
All right, Zachary Lafer, your team won the division championship. Now what are you going to do?
I'm going to go to Disneyland.
All right. Now in the World Series game, you pitched an inning. You came out. How did you feel when you were pitching in that game?
Awkward.
Was it a lot of fun?
Yeah.
And what's your favorite position to play in the game?
Pitcher.
You like playing pitcher best? And what's your favorite memory about the season and what you think your team and you did best?
Hit the ball.
Scored a lot of runs?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, thanks, Zach. Great game.
Mason, you scored the tying run on a steal of home plate. What did you see on that play?
Nothing.
You didn't see anything? What made you go?
The ball passing the plate and missing the ball.
And you pitched a little bit today. What was it like being up on the mound?
Well, awesome. I'm the best.
And Mason, you play a lot of sports. What's your favorite sport?
Football.
What's your second favorite sport, Mason?
Cross.
Mason, when are we going to get to baseball?
Fourth.
Baseball's better than homework, right?
That's not a hard question.
Thank you, Mason. Great season.
Yeah, no.
Adam Snyder, great season. What did you think of the game today?
Felt really good. I think it's a really good privilege to be in the World Series.
So you're going to come back again next fall to the Little League?
Yes, of course I will.
That's going to be awesome. What was your highlight for the season?
Well, my favorite part of the season was hitting the ball really hard.
In any particular game or just in general?
Just in general.
And what's your favorite subject to school?
I have to say science.
Thank you, Adam. Great season. Nick Aguilar, you were the starting pitcher today. Is that a big privilege?
It was. It was really fun, and I struck a couple people out, and it was really fun.
So besides playing pitcher, you played first base, and you played a little bit of outfield today. What's your favorite position?
First base, and then probably pitcher. But first base, my number one.
And what was your highlight for the season?
Probably three triples and a lot of doubles and singles and hits. So I think that was the highlight of my season.
How about catching a line drive in the championship game? What do you think of that?
Like, for a second I thought I was going to drop it, but then I just caught it.
All right. So. Thank you, Nick. Great season. John Egger, you made a couple of plays at first base today. What was that like?
Easy.
And what's your favorite position out there?
First base.
And what about hitting? I think you got on base today, right?
Yep.
So what was the highlight? What was the biggest play of the season for you?
When I hit that triple all the way out to, right field.
Awesome. And what's your favorite subject in school, John?
Math.
Why is that?
Because I like using numbers.
Great. Thank you, John. Great season. Nolan, you had a lot of big hits late in the season. Did you change what you were doing?
A little. I just started practicing a lot, and then I started getting more hits.
That's great. So were you practicing at home or practicing with the team or just with your neighbors?
I practice with my dad every day.
That's awesome. So what's your favorite position on the field?
Well, I like pitcher because you get the most action.
What's your second favorite?
Well, I also like shortstop too.
That's great. And what's your favorite subject in school?
I like science and PE.
And what do you like to do in your free time?
I just do whatever I feel like.
Okay, that's great. Thanks, Nola. Josh Friedenberg, how was your season?
Good.
What was the highlight of the season for you?
I don't know. I like the whole season.
That's great. And what's the favorite position?
Second base.
You made a couple outs in the division championship, and then I think you made another out today. Is that right?
Yeah.
So what was the key to making those outs late in the season?
I just practice and work hard.
That's great. And you've got an extra medal around your neck right now. We'll show that to the camera. What did you get that for?
It's a sportsmanship award. Like you being nice to your coaches, the opponent, and your team.
Okay. Congratulations on the sportsmanship award and great season, Josh.
What do I say?
Thank you.
Tyler Lyons, you had a great game today. How did it feel?
Good.
So there was an interesting play at third. What happened?
The hitter grounded one, and it had a bad bounce, caught me off guard, and hit me in the lip, but I kept it in front of me so they didn't get any other bases.
Wow, you really took one for the team there, didn't you?
Yeah.
All right, so what's your favorite position that you played this season and also in this game?
Pitcher.
You really like pitching, huh?
Yeah.
All right, and you get some good hits, too?
Yeah.
All right, great. Well, great season for you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Nick McKinstry, you had a great game today. You guys are division champs. How did you feel about the game?
I felt pretty good about it. We had some great hits, great defense, and pretty much everything was pretty good.
So now you got a pretty good hit there, didn't you?
Yeah, two-run triple.
How'd that feel, really connecting with the ball? That really sailed, didn't it?
Yeah, I loaded up, waited for it, and just ripped it.
That was a great shot. Really helped the team out, didn't it?
Yep.
All right, so you guys are division champs now. Throughout the season, what was your favorite position to play?
Probably first base or pitcher. Got most of the outs there. Probably the highlight of my games most of the time.
Great. Well, great game, great season. Well done. All right, I'm here with Abel Walker. He's one of the members of the Camo Padres, division champs this year. He just played in the World Series game. How are you feeling?
Good.
During the game, what's your favorite position to play?
Shortstop.
All right. Now, there was one play today. It was really a defining moment of the game, and the other team hit a huge sailing hit to center field. You were playing center field at the time. What happened?
I caught a very good ball that was super high.
Yeah, that was a great catch, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, I think the fans really enjoyed that. That was an exciting moment in the team game. So what really set the tone for the game, do you think?
Maybe defense mostly, like the pitchers were good. Second base, almost all the second base got all the outs out early.
So, and how are you feeling? You going to come back next year and play hard again?
Yes.
All right. Well, great season. All right, I'm here with Kobe Germain of the Camo Padres, division champs this year. Kobe, what did you think of the game today in the World Series?
Well, it was tough, and that's all I have to say about that. It was tough.
So, you had a great season, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
And what's your favorite position to play?
Second base.
All right. Now, I've heard from some of the people watching the games that you're a really good dancer. What's up with that?
Well, it's just a hobby that I have. That's really it.
So I heard you had some really great moves out in the outfield. Is that to distract the batters?
Yes.
All right. Well, that's what we thought. Well, a great season, a great game today. Well done. Thank you, Kobe. All right. I'm here now with Alex Wasilewski Alex, you had a great season and a great game today. You came out and pitched three amazing innings. I see you're holding a trophy there. What's that for?
For coming in first place for the American League.
Division champions. Outstanding. Now, I also noticed that you have something on your head. There's a hat, but there's something above that. What's that all about?
It's a tiara. Since it's a Cinderella story, we won two games and tied two games for the regular season.
Now, were you actually wearing that during the game?
No, I was not.
Are you going to wear it later tonight?
Probably.
All right, and I saw your dad, who's the head coach, he seemed to be having one too. And I saw some a tiara and some makeup on. What's up with that?
Yes. He did it this morning.
He did it this morning. Was that a little embarrassing?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, but he did a great job this season as our coach, and you really did an amazing job today and throughout the season. So what's your favorite position to play? Is it pitcher?
I like to play first base and pitcher.
And you also had some great hits this season and today, too. How'd that feel?
It feels good when I finally rip one.
All right, well, great season to you and your dad that helped bring us along. It was a Cinderella story, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
All right, well, great job. All right, I'm here with Doug Farre, who's one of the members of the Camo Padres, division champions this year. Doug, how do you rate the season for you guys?
Really good.
The regular season was awful.
It was awful. Well, so what happened then in the playoffs?
We came back and we went to the World Series.
The World Series, awesome. And so what was your favorite position in the World Series game, you think?
Probably a shortstop.
Shortstop, and you had some great plays, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
All right, and so do you remember back in the regular season, one of the most fun plays? Weren't you involved in a double play?
Yes.
And what happened? How'd that work out?
So, I caught the ball, and then I threw it to catch home, and he was out by 6 feet, and then the guy who was on first base went to second, then the catcher threw it to me, and then I tagged him out.
And tagged him out. And so was there a reward for that?
We got pizza.
Pizza, well done. Well, you did an extraordinary job today and throughout the rest of the season. You going to come back next season and play hard?
I'm not going to do next season because I'm already on two travel balls teams.
So. Okay, so you're going to play two travel ball games or two teams? All right. Well done, Doug, and great season. All right, I'm here with Jacob Adams. He is on the Camo team, really did a great job throughout the playoffs and then came out in the World Series firing. How did you feel about the game today?
It was a really exciting game, just going out there and having fun, even when our team was on a losing streak through the season.
So a losing streak during the season, but what happened in the playoffs?
I guess we had more practices and we started getting better during the practices and better during the games.
And you guys never gave up, did you?
No, we did not.
All right, and that's what brought us to the last game of the season. So we won division championship, and then we came to the World Series and tied. How do you feel about the World Series game?
Well, it's really exciting just to come out and play for your team and to support them.
So you're coming out in the World Series game when you guys were already division champions. Were you nervous coming out to bat and coming out to the field?
A little, yes.
A little, but you really did what you needed to do and came out with a tie, right? It's not a win, but at least it's a tie, right?
Yeah.
So you're feeling pretty good about the game?
Yes.
All right, well, great season.
Thanks to you, too.
All right. I'm here with Omar Nuheli, and he's wearing something very special here. Omar, can you tell us about what you're wearing, that medal?
Well, it's a sportsmanship award for the Scripps Ranch Little League.
And why did you earn that award?
Well, because this year is my first year of baseball, and I showed a difference to the team.
Yeah, and your teammates really appreciated your play on there, and you always kept a positive attitude. Is that right?
Yes.
So how did you feel coming out today? Your team won the division championship, and then now we're in the World Series. How did you feel? Were you nervous at all, or how were your batting and fielding?
At the beginning, I was pretty nervous, but later on in the game, I started to get the game, and I wasn't much nervous at that time because we scored 5 runs in the first inning, and Later on in the inning, I got more later on in the game, I got more nervous because there was a possibility we could have lost.
But we kept on going, and then what happened in the end?
We tied, which means that both teams won.
And so we're all champions, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
Well, great job with your award. Great job on a season winning division championships and realizing that we really never give up. Isn't that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Always fight hard, right?
Yeah.
All right, well, great season, buddy.
Okay.
Carson Baranek, great season. What did you think of the game today?
It was fun. I got really nervous, like, when they got 5 runs in the first inning because that was really crucial in our game today.
So what was the key to you guys coming back?
We just played as hard as we could, and we just kept going and going, and we had great defense, and we had great hitting.
So what did you earn for your team in the middle of the season this year?
I earned yogurt heaven because I got a double because it was my first hit, and my coach was trying to bribe me for a hit.
It's a great season. Thanks for coming out.
Wait, what?
That's it.
Yeah. Okay.
Jacob Pettit, what did you think of your season?
I thought we played pretty good, and that whenever we were down, we always kept fighting, and we would catch up and win a lot.
So what did you guys do to keep fighting?
We just didn't give up, and every time that they got in base, we would, like, just get them out.
So you caught 3 innings today. What's your favorite position on the field?
Either catcher, pitcher, or second base, because all of them, like, you get the ball a lot, and that's one of my favorite parts of the game.
That's great. And what's your favorite subject in school?
Probably math.
And why is that?
Well, I'm just really good at math, and it's really fun for me.
Great. Thanks, Jacob.
Okay, bye.
Benjamin Gass, what was your favorite position to play this season?
Well, my favorite position was pitcher because I had a 0 ERA the whole season.
What do you think the key to having a 0 ERA was?
I think is hitting your spots and, well, throwing the right way and kind of jamming them.
Do you remember how many innings you pitched for a 0 ERA?
I think I pitched 5.
Maybe 3 2/3?
Maybe.
Maybe. So what about the 2 hits you got in the last 2 playoff games? How'd that help your team?
Well, that helped us because it was a key hit, and that has helped us win the game.
So what about your teammates? How did it feel to be on the Brown Padres this season?
Well, it felt great because I like these uniforms. I like the Padres uniforms.
And being part of the team, how was that?
It was fun.
What about the coaches? Did you have a great coaching staff this season?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, thank you, Benjamin.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Benjamin Gass, and I'd like to thank the Padres for providing uniforms, and I'd like to thank the coaches for helping our teams every year, and I'd like to thank the players for trying their best every single game, and it was really fun this season. Thank you.